As the world's largest wind turbine manufacturer, Vestas has taken wind power mainstream. So what's the outlook for renewable energies worldwide?
I believe we have a very strong future because we have a very strong offering. We have five arguments for wind power. We call it Vestas High Five. One, it's financially competitive. We can do power today down to 4, 5, 6, 7 eurocents per kilowatt. That is in the neighborhood of oil and gas and coal and what have you. The wind is predictable. People are starting to acknowledge the fact that on a given site, you know the amount of wind, the volume, year in, year out. Of course, there will be a little variation every now and then. And this is very important, you know the price, it's zero. And then we have three, it's independent, it's a local job, you are in charge of your own energy destiny. Four, it's fast. We can put up a fair amount of turbines in a few quarters. I mean, nuclear takes you a decade or more, and you don't know the cost, by the way. And finally, it's clean. There's no NOx, no SOx, no carbon, and we don't consume water. So that's why we have a very strong offering, the Vestas High Five. And again, going forward, with 2 billion people on this planet, I think we can compete with any type of energy you can imagine.
We're here at your main R&D facility. What work goes on here?
Among other things, we look into the design of our blades, because that's where we harvest the wind, so to speak. Optimizing it, and also the shape and the surface, is extremely important. The overall trick is, of course, to make sure that a Vestas turbine is as light as possible. Another important activity here is at our monitoring center. We monitor live data from 31,000 megawatts. That equals 15% of global installed wind power base. Because live data is the backbone of the future development of Vestas.
Vestas has had a remarkable year in a very challenging business environment. So what have been the highlights for you?
If you go back to 2010, definitely we made some mistakes. No doubt, to do a profit warning is a mistake. Having said that, the market has materialized exactly the way we predicted. It has moved from quantity to quality, and that's why Vestas got her fair share of the action, so to speak. We got an order intake of almost 8,700 megawatts, or 8.7 gigs, which is very satisfactory, at good prices, by the way.
How does Vestas maintain its position as market leader? In other words, what is its uniqueness?
We have made two very important decisions some years ago. One, to internationalize the company. A few years ago, we did almost everything back home in Denmark. That is obviously not a sustainable business model, financially and carbon-wise. Two, we have invested tons of money in R&D, like where we are today, our core R&D center. Because this is all about quality. And I believe that maybe we are not the first, but among the very first, to see this change from quantity to quality. And again, the market is tough today, and in a tough market, only the strong guys survive.
So how important is it that renewable energy receives political backing on a local, national, and international level?
It is important, because this is in for the long term, and we need long-term line of sight to the markets in which we operate. In the case of wind, we need political support to build out the grid into the middle of nowhere where the turbines, for obvious reasons, are generating power. We also need the politicians to agree on where to put up the turbines. This is basically what we need. Having said this, and now while we talk about support, subsidies, they're also called, if you take a look on the amount of money put into clean tech compared to the amount of subsidies into classic fuel, we can only dream about the money being put into fossil fuel, so to speak.
So what would you say is the ticket to entry in the global energy market right now?
In global energy market, and I can only speak about wind power, obviously, as we become more and more mainstream, barriers to entry grow, because a few years ago, you could buy a turbine for fun. It didn't really matter how they performed. But if you buy 500 or 5,000 turbines and they're deeply integrated into your grid and energy backbone, then you have to make sure that the turbines perform exactly as you expect. So quality is ticket to entry.
Finally, Vestas is attracting enormous interest from media and investors. What's driving the upturn at the company?
I would say it's our pole position in clean tech. When we saw it coming some years ago, we were mentally not prepared. On the other hand, we also concluded that if there was one company who deserved this pole position, it was us. So we decided to relocate our quarterly presentations to London and also New York, not to accommodate the stock market, but to be in fast access to London and also New York media to hit the world in a few split seconds, so to speak.
Peter Kruse, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.